Javi Martinez sending it through. Kimmich teeing himself up and finding the bottom corner.
Nice.
YouTube, what's going on, boys? We're back for another video. And for today's video, boys, we're going to be taking a look at this brand new Informed Joshua Kimmich card. And yeah, I know he's not on my team, but just give me a sec, all right? But boys, before anything, I'd appreciate if you guys do like the video and subscribe to the channel. We're almost at 3K subs. Probably by the time you guys are watching this, we're going to be at 3,000 subs. So I want to appreciate you guys. Like, you guys are the best. I see all the love, all the feedback, everything. And trust me, I'm taking it. I'm responding to every comment that I do see. So if you guys comment something, I'm going to respond to it. As long as, it's not racial or anything bad. But boys, we're comparing both the Joshua Kimmich cards right here, and you guys do see the difference in stats. And while we do that, I want to sell out for just like five to ten seconds, so just allow me. All right, yeah, my bad, boys, I know. But I'm working on this Wheel of FUT series, and I appreciate if you guys do check it out. It's going to be linked in the description of the video at the end of the video. And also, you guys should see a little link pop up right now. So after this video, if you guys do want to check it out, trust me, it's going to be worth your time. It's something that not a lot of YouTubers do. If anything, nobody has done it yet, so it's kind of unique to this channel. So I'd appreciate it if you guys do check it out, share it, all that stuff. But boys, enough of that selling out, boys. I feel bad, but we put a shadow on him, and just like his gold card, he was insane. Now, is he worth the upgrade? That's what we're going to be talking about in this video. Just a little disclaimer, we did play 5 Division Rivals games with him, so obviously it's not a lot, but trust me, considering that I've used his gold card for almost 100 games at this point, I was like, you know what, let's just get him, review him, and see what's up. See, like, if he feels a bit different, and he did. Like, honestly, he kind of did. Compared to his gold card, it felt a bit better. Like, in terms of pace, like, he felt faster. Obviously, because of the shadow card. But his gold card did feel kind of slow, but not very, very slow, if that makes sense. Overall, I feel like low-key, it's not worth the upgrade yet because he's really expensive. But down the line, maybe he gets, like, a player of the month or something. I would have for sure upgraded to the player of the month. But if you like the inform, you know, card work and stuff like that, I would say try him out. He feels better, like, defensively. He's more aware. Like, he just feels faster, all that stuff. You guys are going to be seeing some gameplay right here. This is just one half of a game. Just a little side note. Man's is struggling out here to talk. But throwing that out the window, just a little side note, boys. He's not really going to be a good scoring option. If anything, he's a very, very good playmaker. So if you guys are looking to buy him just for goal scoring, he's obviously going to score some goals for you if he's open. He has some decent shooting stats. But if you're looking to, you know, just use him as a goal scorer, just don't even bother trying to, you know, get him. He's still really, really good, like, in terms of playmaking, as I said, with passing the ball, over the top through balls, long balls, short passes, 1-2s, all that stuff. Like, if you're under pressure, because I know in this FIFA a lot of people put pressure after losing the possession or something like that, well, I forget what it's called, but I know a lot of people use that in their team, and it's very, very effective. But with his short passing, it's very easy to counter, and you could easily get on an easy counter attack with Joshua Kimmich. Players that I kind of do want to compare to him, just because, like, in terms of moving fast, agile, like, really good, and cheaper alternatives, obviously we're going to go with his gold card. Frankie de Jong is also a good one. Valverde is also a good one. Fred is also a good one from the Premier League. But if you're looking for a Bundesliga type player like that, Lemire, I think his name is, he's decent, but obviously not the best. But if anything, I would go with Zakaria if you cannot afford his gold card or Joshua Kimmich's inform card. And boys, Zakaria is just nasty. Like, if he gets an inform card, he's gonna go up to 85 overall, and he's gonna be broken. Trust me when I say that. His gold card is already broken, and once he does get the inform card, he's gonna be even more broken. And please excuse the damn gameplay, boys. Like, I don't know what I was doing here. I can't tell if I was checking my phone at this time and I was just passing it around, being a little meathead. But we didn't lose this game, we just drew it. But I was like, you know what, who cares? Like, I just needed some gameplay, and I'm sorry. I promise you guys, I put effort into my videos. I know it doesn't seem like it, but trust me, boys, trust me, I put a lot of effort into my player reviews. Oh my god, it doesn't seem like it with this, but yeah, trust me, it's not what it looks like. All right, but anyways, so just a little recap. His pace, he feels very fast. Well, not very fast, but he feels fast tracking back on defense. So I love that about him. Shooting, I honestly did not take that many shots with him just because he was either in the back or in the middle. I told him to stay outside the box, which is why he never had any shooting opportunity. So I can't really tell you guys about his shooting. But considering he has a gold card that I've used so many times, he is decent at shooting at the most. Like, if he's open, he's going to make it as long as you slot it in the near post. If you're going to smash it in the near post, or you can just finesse it to the far post, he's going to make that 7 times out of 10. Obviously, he's not a goal scorer, so just don't keep that in mind. He did score one goal at the inform card, but it was just a tap-in, so I kind of don't really count that. I don't know. I guess positioning with him is really good. That's another thing, defensive positioning. I don't know how I forgot about that because he's a central defensive midfielder. But defensive positioning is really good, boys. And if you do the LTRT defending type, like how you do with N'Golo Kante, he's a freaking stud, and he covers spaces very, very quick. So if you like using N'Golo Kante for that, he's kind of like a cheaper alternative to N'Golo Kante. Even his inform is cheaper than N'Golo Kante, obviously. So if you're looking for an N'Golo type player, I feel like Kimmich is very, very comparable to him. And he's very, very cheap. His passing, as I said, moving on, is good. Like, his short passing, long passing, crossing, all that stuff is very good. And that's another reason why I've had his gold card for so, so long. I've had him as a CDM, and personally for me, I really love Joshua Kimmich as a central midfielder, just because as a CDM, you rely too much on him on defensively, if that kind of makes sense. But because I did have Marcus Llorente, I relied on him more as a CDM, but I relied more on Kimmich as a central midfielder. I don't know if that makes sense, but hopefully it does. Dribbling, like I said, LTRT was really good, but you can't really, you know, base that off dribbling. And again, look at the dumbass play that I'm doing, boys. What are we doing? Sorry for language, but dribbling, I kind of didn't really dribble with him. If anything, I kind of just passed the ball, you know, pass here, pass there type of player with Joshua Kimmich is what I use him for. Not really too much to hold the ball. However, when I'm out muscling a player or shielding the ball, he's really, really effective in that. He's kind of strong for a midfielder. So when a forward tries to steal the ball from him, they're not going to even bother because he's kind of strong. And then defensively, he's just a stud. Like, his tackling stats are really, really good. He had one play in one of the 5 games, but I just didn't record every single game because I was like, you know what? I know how he plays, and his inform just felt a bit better, if that makes sense. But he had one opportunity where the opponent was on a 1-2 counterattack, and then Joshua Kimmich just, you know, lunged very, very, very good and just stopped the freaking counterattack, stopped the goal opportunity. And in terms of physicality, as I said, he's a strong midfielder. He may not seem like it if he comes up against somebody who's really, really aggressive, like an Eric Cantona or like a Diego Costa. I know nobody uses him, but you never know. Just as aggressive players, he's going to outmuscle them. He might struggle a bit with some aggressive players, but as long as you know how to shield the ball, he's going to be very, very good. Overall, boys, value-wise, if you could get him for like 150k or cheaper, I feel like he'd be a really, really good card. But if you don't want to spend coins on him, I'm sorry, then just go with his gold card. It's almost the same thing, but he just feels a bit faster and more defensively aware, which is what I love about him. And using his inform is really good, but I know his price is gonna go down, so I just sold him. But overall, boys, value wise like I said, probably like a 7 out of 10. If he gets cheaper, then I'll probably give it like a 9 out of 10. And then just the card overall is a 10. Or probably like a 9, just because you can't really score with, well, you can, but he's just not, for me, he's not a goal scorer. He's just a defensive player and a playmaker. But boys, hopefully the review did help y'all decide. Hopefully this did make sense. If not, I'll just kind of explain it if you guys have any questions in the comments below. I really, really appreciate you guys. Like, I really do. So I appreciate the hell out of you. And thank you guys for watching all my videos. Thank you for all the love. Thank you for all the feedback. Shout out to everybody that's been coming in from Footbin. And shout out to my Brazilians. I know I've been seeing a couple of Brazilians in here, boys. Like, what are we saying, boys? That's love right there, man. I appreciate y'all so much. Don't do anything stupid, boys. And I'll see you on the next one, babies. Peace out.